Hi, I'm Adam Glazier, a UX designer on the Google Cast team. If you're new to Cast, Cast is a way for people to get content from your app to their TV. And in this video, I'll show you why Cast works the way it does so that you can be informed while designing your app. Now, for the sake of simplicity, the examples I'll share focus on casting and controlling video. However, it's worth noting that you can also cast other types of media, such as music, games, and photos. Now, when designing for Cast, there are three main things to consider. Your app is the remote. So just like a TV remote, your app should make it easy for anyone to control a Cast at any time. People need instant control no matter what state their device is in. Second, it's a shared experience. When your app is casting, expect that others are in the room. Some will be watching, some will contribute, and some will need to take control. Third is that it's cross-platform. The living room has many devices in it, and the more devices that can control your cast, the more seamless it will feel. Now, because casting is a new action, its usage depends on people being reminded that it's available. An easy way to do this is to show a one-time cast introduction screen. This intro will help users new to casting and also help experienced users know that your app is now cast-enabled. So placing the cast icon at the top right of every screen in your app will allow users to start and control casts at any time. And to be clear, the cast icon should always be visible whenever a cast receiver is available. Now, once users are ready to cast, they can do that in two ways. They can connect to a cast receiver and then play content, or they can start playing content and then connect to a receiver. Either way they start, Cast is a mode of the app. So just like Bluetooth, once you're connected, whatever you play in the app should cast to the TV. Now, once content starts streaming to the TV, the phone allows users to browse and control casts, while the TV displays the streaming content. Now, when designing your TV UI, do not make it look touchable, simply reuse the tablet UI. For example, in research I've observed, people attempted to use the physical TV remote when the UI on the TV looked interactive. So with this in mind, when you tap pause on the phone, it changes to a play icon, and the TV shows the pause icon. This is because the TV is showing the state and the phone is providing the action. The second tip is to help the TV UI stay out of the way. For instance, people will sometimes pause a video to examine a frame or read text on the screen like closed captions. So when someone pauses a video, fade the TV UI away after 5 seconds. Keeping the UI within the lower fourth of the TV will also help, since most of the important content is typically above that. The last tip is to provide the ability to control a cast from every state of your app. At any given time, the most critical controls for people are play and pause and volume. Remember, this is super important because your app is the only remote they have. Now on Android, there's 5 places to surface controls. You can provide a full set of controls in your app for the content currently playing. And when navigating elsewhere in your app, provide a persistent controller. This is commonly a control bar at the bottom of every screen. Also, provide controls within the cast menu, because this is where users start and stop casting. And when users exit your app, make sure to provide controls in notifications and the lock screen. Doing all of these together will ensure the most seamless experience so that your users can relax and use their phone however they like. Now, once something's casting, expect that more users will want to join in. So at a minimum, when multiple users are connected, each user should be able to take control. An example of this is that if you left the room while casting, your friend should be able to take control. Another possibility is that you started a cast and your friends want to add to the queue. So designing your app to work for anyone at any time will help it feel extra natural. Now, from time to time, expect that the phone's connection to a cast may go in and out. This can happen from the Wi-Fi going out of range, the phone battery dying, or your app's processes being stopped by another app. When this happens, automatically reconnect users that dropped off whenever they're in your app. The final step to a cast is disconnecting. Users can disconnect from the cast menu and also from a notification in Android. Now, to prevent users from accidentally stopping a cast, make sure to only stop the cast when the last connected user disconnects. For the complete set of Cast UX guidelines, don't forget to check out the design checklist on the Cast SDK site. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.